You and you f***ing Jesus could kiss my ass, okay?
Go away!
Screw you! Whoa. Don't camera, no camera! You f***! Don't take camera! I break your camera, don't take picture! Shabbat shalom, no picture, we don't want picture!
Please!
You need to. You can't come in here. This is not your house.
This is not your house.
We killed Jesus. We're proud of him.
Did you record that?
This is my land.
This is not your land. It belongs to these families.
Land, you son of a. We're gonna kill you and the Palestinians. This is my land. God gave it to me. You.
I want to talk a little bit. This is why we're all here. Ethics and the idea. What is so unique about what my training was? How does it differentiate from the Israeli military, from the American military? How does it differentiate from other militaries around the world? In 1992, Israel decided that they needed to create an ethical statement that combined international law, Israeli law, as well as what it is that the Jewish state wants to have. And they called it Ruach Tzal, which means, it's translated as a spirit of the IDF. They break it down into several different categories. We're going to talk about these different categories. The first is responsibility. The soldier's actions shall be characterized by constant involvement, initiative, and diligence, demonstrating good judgment. Human dignity. The IDF and its soldiers are obligated to preserve human dignity. All human beings are of inherent value, regardless of race, creed, nationality, gender, status, or role. It sounds a lot like the Declaration of Independence, and in many ways it is. It is the idea that all soldiers are created, are forced to maintain a strict level of decency for all people, regardless of who they are, where they come from, Palestinian, Israeli, Jewish, anything at all. That's really a shame. I would have loved if you'd stayed and heard the entire thing, but that's fine. Another part is human life. The soldier shall always act with reason and caution, bearing in mind the supreme value of human life. In a minute, we're going to talk about how this conflicts and how this is related to Hamas's statement.
What about when you use white phosphorus? So, what about that?
Actually, his question's afterwards. So
is that humanitarian when you use white phosphorous on innocent civilians?
Give me the respect I've given you, and if that's how you
want
to do it, then you're
welcome to leave. I can't keep my voice.
Wait, that was the point, though. We didn't want anybody to say anything.
Oh, well, I'm not a part of your group. I'm not a part of your group, so.
Okay.
War criminals will not be allowed at ASU. The Israel Defense Force has been accused numerously of violating the Geneva Conventions. Most of the 1,400 that died in the Gaza 2008 incursion were women and children. This is real. The names of the people on every shirt is a child. We will not, as far as that we're at ASU, make it a place for propaganda for the State of Israel, especially for the Israel Defense Force. White phosphorus in a middle school showered upon the playground of a Gaza school. Did you hear about that? No. We did. We heard the screams of the Palestinian children, and we're here to convey a message to the IDF representative that came to this campus. We will not be fooled